Good morning, dear students. So today we are going to see fundamental operation exercise P. We have to see the multiplication. So I hope all of you know. So fundamental operation. Now in fundamental operations, suppose I have a number like 7xy. When we have to multiply with 3x, then constant will be multiplied with constant. That means 7 threes are 21. X into x will become x square, and there is no y. Is only one y is here. Here we don't have any y. So our answer will be like 21x square y. Now if I have, like 4. Even negative number like 6xyz multiplied with 1 by 2 or minus 1 by 2xy, then what will be my answer? It will be like 2 ones are 2, 2 threes are 6, and minus 1. 3 into minus 1 will be equal to minus 3. X into x will become x square, y into y becomes y square, z into no z this side. So it will be copied as it is. So this will be our answer. I hope all of you know how to multiply the numbers. Now this was the case like one term is multiplied with one term. When we have two terms like x and y, x plus y multiplied with 3x, for an example like this, then what we have to do, we have to multiply this term with this number, this whole, and this whole will again be multiplied with this. So all of you know 3 into x will become x square plus 3 into, there is no constant, so now constant will be copied as it is. Y will be multiplied with x, so it will become xy or yx. So one of the same thing. So in this way we will multiply. Suppose if I have like 3x plus 7z minus of 2y multiplied with minus of 2z, for an example. Now again same thing, this whole one term will be multiplied with this. This whole term will be multiplied with this and then with this. And sign conventions obviously we have to take care. Like 3x multiplied with minus of 2x. So first we will multiply the constant. That is coefficient here 3. 3 multiplied by minus 2 will be equal to minus of 6. X will be multiplied with z. So it will become xz. Now plus 7 into minus 2 will become minus of 14. Z into z will become z square. Minus into minus 2 into this is 2. Okay. So minus 2 into minus 2 will become plus 4. Y into z will become yz. So this, in this way, we will multiply. So this was like multiplication of one term with the one term. Both the side we were having one term. Multiplication of binomials with one term. This is multiplication of monomials. Now trinomials we have seen. This was multiplication of trinomial with the one term. Now binomial into binomial also we can multiply like x plus y into x minus of y. These two terms are there, binomial. This is again binomial. The second dividend multiplicand was single term, monomial. Here two terms. So again x into x, x into y, y into x, y into y. So it will become like x square plus x square, and then plus into minus will become minus of xy, y into x will become yx, and then plus into minus y square. Yx, xy will get cancelled. So you will have x square minus y square. Now, if you know, this was the formula of a square minus b square. I could have done that also, but I did not do. Just to show how we are going to multiply the terms. If I have like 3xz plus of 4y multiplied with 2x plus of 3 or minus, you take minus 3y. Then this will be multiplied with this. So 3 2s are 6, x into x, x square, x into z. That means z only, z will remain here. Now 2x into plus of 4, that means 4 2s are 8xy, minus of 3 into this, minus of 3 means minus 9, and then xyz. This minus into plus minus, 4 into 3 12, and then y and y square. So in this way you all will complete this exercise. I hope there won't be any problem. Multiplication by monomial with monomial, binomial with monomial, trinomial with monomial, or binomial with binomial, trinomial with trinomial. You have to just follow. Each and every individual should be multiplied with the terms present there. And then we will be, you have to take care of the sign.
whichever sign is there, you have to multiply plus into minus, minus into plus, and all those things. I hope with this concept you will be able to solve exercise P. Now I will be discussing exercise C, in which you are having division part. So that let me clean the board so that it will be easy for me to explain you. Now in division part, we have like various type of terms, like in multiplication also we saw about monomial, monomial, binomial, trinomial, and all those things. Here also we have the various terms. Now the very first example rule says that when we have monomial and it is divided by a monomial, then how you are going to divide? Suppose here we are having 8x by 4. This is what we have to divide. So 8x by 4. Constant will be multiplied with the constant. 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8. So it will become 2x. Now this was monomial. I hope there is no problem. Now if you go by like 3x by minus 1. So it will be 3x divided by minus 1. You know, in denominator you are having minus. So you can take this into numerator. So it will become minus of 3x. So this was like division of monomial by monomial. Now if we have, and the condition here, and the numbers were coefficient, where sorry, the denominators were a constant number, so you have just simplified the constants. You have simplified the constant, you have reduced the constant. That is called crossing the constant or cutting the constant. Now second type, you are having like 13ab by a. You have to divide this. Then what you are going to do, same procedure, 13a by b whole divided by a. Here we don't have any constant, so constant cannot be divided. Here we are having variable a, so variable a is written one time. Here also it is written one time, so one time and one time both will be cancelled. So your answer will be remaining as 13b. Suppose you have, instead of this, you could have, they have mentioned a square b by a. Then what you were supposed to do, 13a square by b divided by a. So a ones are a two times it is given, so you can write a one time, it is a into a, that means two times indirectly it is like a into b, and a is here, a cancelled, so you will be left with 13ab, right? So here what I have done, I have just cancelled and then one time I have written a. So in this way you are going to simplify. Like another example, m divided by minus m. M divided by minus m means m upon minus m. Here we have minus sign, so mm will cancel, it will become minus 1. This minus will go up and then mm has to be cancelled. As you all know, it is very easy. Now second number, like seventh number, it is given a very big number, like minus of 63 x cube y raised power 5 z raised power 8 divided by 9 x cube y square z. Okay, now constant will be divided by constant, variables will be divided by variables, corresponding variables. 9 ones are 9, 9 sevens are 63, minus will remain, x cube cancelled. Here y square and here 5 times it is given, that means it will become y cube, z one time, z 7, so it will become z raised power 7. Therefore, your answer will be minus of 7, y cube, z of 7. So in this way, you all can solve this particular questions. Now we have another. This was like binomial with monomial. Now the question number 3 says that binomial with monomial. Suppose I have question number 3 says binomial by monomial. Okay. Now question number 3, ax plus of by whole divided by x. It is division. Now how you're going to separate this, how you're going to solve this is bx, sorry, here bx is given. So one thing is that you can take out the common factors, as we all have studied factorization. So we can take out the common here x, and then we will be left with a plus b by x. Now x cancelled, so we will be having a plus b as the answer. Now if you don't want to follow this method, then you can also write ax upon x plus bx upon x, right? And then if you take LCM, again you will reach this position only. So x cancelled, you are left with a plus b. So this is method 1 and method 2 concept I have taught. Either you can take out the common terms outside and then simplify, or else separate the denominators and numerators separately, giving in the value, separating the terms. Now second, like you are having 9. Okay, let me first clean the board so that it will be easy for you all.
Now we have like question number 3 subpart 5. Okay, question number 3 subpart 5, they have mentioned like 9x power 6 minus of 6x power 4 minus of 3x cubed divided by minus of 3x square. Now here, if you want to simplify by method 1, what you are going to do here is, you will first try to find out x square, you have to take out x cube, x4, x6. That means x square a term you can easily take out outside. So it will become x square. Now, again you are having 3s also. There 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6 and 3 threes are 9. That means common factor can also be taken as 3 here. So 3x square if you take out common, so you will be left with 3x power 4 minus 2x power 2 minus of 3 means 1. And then x is already, x square is already taken. So x whole divided by minus of 3x square. Now 3x square cancelled, minus is there. So what you can do, you can just interchange because this minus will go at the top. So it will become minus of 3x power 4 minus into minus will become plus 2x square plus of x. So this will be your answer. Or second method, as I have told you, method 2. This was method 1, by separating the terms. Like you can write x power 6 by minus of 3x square. Then it is given minus of 6x power 4 by minus of 3x square. Minus of 3x cube by minus of 3x square. Now 3 3s are 9. X square cancelled. So you are left with x power 4. 3 2s are 6 cancelled. X square cancelled. X square will be. X square 3 3 cancelled. So you are left with x minus. Now minus into 3 will be minus of 3x power 4, minus into minus will become plus 2x square, minus into minus will become plus x. So this is what you got the answer here and here. So whichever method you like, you all can solve either taking out the common factors and simplifying or separating the terms based upon the symbols given in the questions. So this is what we can do. Now this was like binomial, trinomials, division by monomial. Now question number 4 says that we have to divide. What is given here? We are having trinomial divided by binomial. Like a square minus of 15a plus of 54 whole divided by a plus of a minus of 6. A minus of 6. So you are going to divide by this term. Now if you go by this method of division, you will not be able to achieve the target. So what you have to do, you have to use the old method that you used to solve in this way, and then you will get the answers. So you all can use this method. So what is the procedure? You all first see very slowly and lightly, you see, don't take the pressure on your mind. So first of all, you have to write as you used to write, like 6 divided by 2. 6 divided by 2, 6 used to coincide, and this was the divisor, this was the dividend and quotient and remainder, I hope all of you know. Now, a minus 6, so this is my divisor. Now, a should be multiplied how many times to get a square? It will be multiplied with a times, a into a will give you a square. Now, minus 6 will again be multiplied with that coefficients, that quotient, that is minus 6 into a will be equal to minus of 6a. Now you have to subtract, as you all have understood how we do the subtraction. We put the sign here and then again we interchange the sign. That means interchanging the sign. A square minus a square will be cancelled. Minus of 15 plus of 6. This old sign will be discarded. We will not take into consideration. So minus 15a plus of 6a will be equal to 9. Minus of 9a, 9, 6, 15 and positive negative sign. Now another number you will bring, that is 54. Now minus 9 you want, a should be multiplied with what number to get minus 9? It should be multiplied with minus 9. A into minus 9 will be equal to minus 9. Minus 6 into 9 will be equal to plus of 54. Now change of sign, change of sign. So this old sign minus will be removed, no need of taking into consideration. So plus minus 9 will become 0. And then plus 54 and minus 54 will again become 0. So your quotient will be equal to a minus 9. Finally, you can write like a square minus of 15a plus of 54 divided by a minus 6 will be equal to a minus of 9. In this way, you can write and leave your answers after doing the division part in the fair part. This division you have to do in the fair part. Do not use the rough part of your page. You have to show it on the fair calculation. And then if you want, you can leave up to here also. Or else one more step you can write. You can write the dividend and divisor is equal to this much value, whatever you have got. If you will get remainder, then remainder will remain as it is. Now I will be taking another problem so that it will be easy for you. Now in that question number 4, you were supposed to verify also, as I hope all of you know how to verify. That means divisor should be multiplied with the quotient, and then what was the answer you were getting, you were supposed to verify that. Now we have one question like question number 5a. I would like to solve here question number 5a. We have to divide 8m cube plus of 8m square plus of 4m plus of 1 divided by 1 plus 2m. Correct. Now if you go by 1 plus 8m and 2m, then it will be difficult. What you can do, you can just arrange the divisor in such a way that you should be getting one coefficient. That means instead of writing 1 plus m, I can write 2m plus 1. Yes or no? By interchanging, our answers will become easy. It will be easy for us to calculate, because m, this is in decreasing order. m cube, m square, m, and then the constant. That means there is no variable. So this divisor should be also in that particular order. If it is not in arranged form, then first is that we should arrange the numbers. So luckily we are having the numbers are in arranged form. So only divisor we have to arrange it. It was written 1 plus 2m. So 1 plus 2m can be written as 2m plus m. Decreasing order of their degrees. Decreasing order of their degrees. Decreasing order of their powers. Not degrees, sorry. Decreasing order of their powers. We have to arrange both the side. Dividend as well as divisor. Now 2 should be multiplied how many times to get 8? 4 times. And to get m cube, I need here m square. Right? 2 should be multiplied 4 times to get 8m, and m should be multiplied m square times to get m cube. So here I will have 8m cube. Then this 1 should will be multiplied with 4m, so it will be 4m square, so it will become 4m square. Now subtraction, as you know, our sign change method, so this will be cancelled, 0. Plus 8m square minus, because old sign will be neglected, we will not consider that. So 8 minus 4m square will be equal to 4m square. Next term, 4m will be copied. Now, to get 4m square, I need plus of 2m. So 2 2s are 4m square. 1 into 2m, that is 2m. Now, change of sign again. So this will be cancelled. 4 minus 2 will be equal to 2m. And then plus 1. To get 2m plus 1, I need 1 time. So I will have 2m plus 1. Change of sign. So it will be answered. It will be 0, and the quotient will be equal to this much. So you can write 8m cube plus 8m square plus of 4m plus of 1 divided by 2m plus 1 is equal to 4m square plus of 2m plus of 1. This is your answer. Now if they are asking you to verify, then you have to write verification. Okay, verify. Or you say verification you are going to do. So what you are going to do, you are going to multiply the quotient 4m square plus of 2m plus of 1 multiplied with 2m plus 1. All of you know how to multiply. That means 8m is cube, then this will be multiplied with this, it will become 4m square. This will be multiplied with this, 4m square. This will be multiplied with this, 2m. This will be multiplied with, so 2m plus 1. Now you have 8m cube plus of 8m square plus of 4m plus of 1. I hope it is clear. In this way, you are supposed to solve all the remaining sums up to question number 5 we have discussed. Question number 6 also, you have to follow same procedure as well as question number 7. In question number 7, you have trinomial as the divisor. In question number 2, you have binomial as the divisor with the highest degree of 2. So in this, I hope you won't be having any problem. My dear students, you please try to solve.